What happened to the Sixgills of the Northwest? Their disappearance remained a mystery. Back in Seattle, researchers Phil Levin and Kelly Andrews scoured the tracking data for answers.
I mean, they all left at different times of the year.
I mean, every time we'd launch the boat, we'd put our receivers in, you know, we're getting pings from the sharks right in this area. Pretty much every single one of our tracks is going right along the waterfront and back, right along the waterfront and back. Maybe out here.
Really, not so much across, right?
Yeah, nothing through the middle. It's always right along the edges of the bay.
They traced the path of the animals that gathered around Seattle's waterfront. And in the mid-2000s, noticed a dramatic change in behavior.
So at first we're seeing movements like from here to here, or here to here. And now we're talking about in the space of just a few weeks, really, right? We're talking going from here all the way out
to the straits, which ends up leading to the ocean.
Yes.
They were clearly going faster than before and in much more of a straight line. They weren't just meandering, they were swimming someplace.
You know, that was sort of our first hint that, whoa, something just happened with these sharks.
The sharks started swimming greater distances. It was as if they were building up for a long journey. Then, one by one, they headed north out of Seattle and away from central Puget Sound to the Strait of Juan de Fuca, and then out to the ocean.
Some turned left and went down to California, some turned right and went up to British Columbia, but it was clear that they were off on their adult life into the Pacific Ocean.
The exodus continued for several months until all the tagged sharks were gone.
We sort of ended our research because there were no animals to easily do this work on.
Phil and Kelly believe that when the young Sixgills reached a certain size, something triggered them to leave Puget Sound and venture into the open ocean.
Basically, they go off the continental shelf and go into deep waters, you know, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 meters deep. And we think this group of babies were growing up in Puget Sound, and as they left Puget Sound, there weren't more to replace them.
The discovery provided a possible explanation for why sharks disappeared, not just from Puget Sound, but from Vancouver Island as well.
This may be a totally natural pattern where, you know, the adults come in, they give birth, and then don't return for several years.
There's compelling evidence that this is the case. But until sharks return, questions will remain.
It's really a great question as to whether these animals will be coming back to the same waters that they grew up in to give birth. That would be a fantastic piece to add to the puzzle.
They will come back. I just don't know when.